Welcome to the spoken tutorial on item review in DSpace. In this tutorial, we will learn to accept an item review task, manage the task, and review an item in DSpace. This tutorial is recorded using Ubuntu Linux OS 18.04. DSpace version 6.3 and Firefox web browser. However, you may use any other web browser of your choice. To practice this tutorial, you should have a working internet connection. Install DSpace 6.3 on your system. Tomcat service should be running. Have reviewer's authority in the collection. If not, then please go through the prerequisite tutorials on this website. To follow this tutorial, you should have knowledge of library science and familiarity with Dublin Core metadata standard. This tutorial assumes that you have done the immediate previous tutorial assignment in this series. If not, please do so before proceeding ahead. Items are reviewed to check the suitability for inclusion in the collection. The objective of item review is quality control, improvements to the bibliographic record, and checking of policy or copyright. Now, let us proceed to accept the item review task. Open a web browser and go to the DSpace interface. Log in to DSpace with a reviewer's account. I will log in with my reviewer's account. You are now in the reviewer's My DSpace page. Tasks in the pool table show some tasks. Reviewers can check the item submissions from the authorized collections only. Tasks in the pool table shows details of each task, like task, which shows a task to be done, item, which is the title of the item, submitted to, which indicates the name of the collection, and submitted by, which is the name of the item submitter. Reviewers can preview the task before finally accepting the task. To preview the specific task, we have to click on the corresponding Take Task button. Now, let us preview an item with the title Single Frame Image Super Resolution Through Contourlet Learning. To do that, click on the corresponding Take Task button next to that particular item. The Preview Task page opens. This page shows the metadata of the item. Files in this item table shows a list of files uploaded for this item. To view a file, click on the View or Open button next to the file name. The file opens in a new tab. Review the file and then close the tab. To accept the task, we have to click on Accept this task button at the bottom right corner. The Perform Task page opens. Perform Task page shows the metadata of the item and the files submitted for the item. Approve, Reject, and Edit metadata buttons are provided here for reviewing the item. Whereas, Do Later and Return Task to Pool buttons are provided to manage the task. If we wish to leave this task for now, then we can use the Do Later option. Click on the Do Later button. We will be redirected to My DSpace page. Now observe that the accepted task is not available in the Tasks in the Pool table. Instead, accepted tasks are shown in the Owned Task table. Thus, in DSpace terminology, accepted tasks are known as owned tasks. To perform the owned task, click on the corresponding Perform This Task button. The Perform Task page opens with details of the item. Next option to manage the task is Return Task to Pool. This option can be used to return the current task to the pool. Click on the Return Task to Pool button. We will be redirected to My DSpace page. Observe that the previously accepted task is now returned to tasks in the pool. Now the returned task can be owned by another reviewer. For this demonstration, I will own the returned task again as shown here. We are back on the Perform Task page. Now, let us learn to review an item using different review options. Before choosing any review option, review the metadata and the files carefully. If the item is suitable for inclusion in the collection, then we can select the Approve option. On choosing the Approve option, the item will be published directly. As I have to update keywords for the item, I will not directly approve the item. To update keywords, click on the Edit Metadata button. Immediately, we will be redirected to the item submission form with the metadata of the item. I have to update keywords, so let us locate the metadata field for keywords. Now update the keywords as shown here. Click on the Next button at the bottom right corner repeatedly until the Perform Task page is reached. Observe that the keywords field is now updated. Ensure that the metadata and the file for the item is correct. Finally, click on the Approve button for the inclusion of the item into the collection. Immediately, the item gets archived and published. A confirmation message is shown saying the submission has been placed in the main archive. DSpace generates an identifier for the item and displays it. To cross-verify the published items, click on the identifier link. Items are displayed with their respective metadata and files. The archived item is publicly visible. The submitter and reviewer cannot edit the archived items. A person with the following roles can edit the archived items: DSpace administrator, authorized community administrator, authorized collection administrator. Also, an email is sent to the submitter which confirms the item inclusion in the collection. Let us proceed to cross-verify the email sent to the submitter. Log in to the submitter's email account now. Here's the email with the subject DSpace Submission Approved and Archived. Open the email. It confirms the acceptance of the item. Also, an identifier for the item is shown. Approved items are successfully included in the collection. Switch back to the DSpace interface. Now let us proceed to learn the remaining options of the item review. Click on the Logged In tab at the top right corner. Select My DSpace from the drop-down. We are now in the My DSpace page of the reviewer. Observe that as the own task is completed, there are no more own tasks shown here. So now let's own another task from the pool. Click on the Take Task button next to the item title, which starts with Design and Analysis. We will be redirected to the Preview Task page. Click on the Accept This Task button at the bottom. Now we are redirected to the Perform Task page. If an item is not suitable for inclusion in the collection, the reviewer can reject the item. For example, description has not been submitted for this item, which is crucial for accepting it. So, this item is not suitable for inclusion into the collection. To reject the item, just click on the Reject button. We will be redirected to the page with the title, Enter Reason for Rejection. Type the reason for rejection in the text box as shown. The typed message should clearly indicate the reason for the rejection. Also mention whether the submitter should fix the problem and resubmit. Then click on the Reject Item button below the text box. The task is now complete. A notification will be sent to the item submitter. Let us proceed to cross-verify the rejection email sent to the submitter. Switch back to the submitter's email account. In the inbox, we see a mail with the subject D space submission rejected. Open the mail. It confirms the rejection of the item. The reason for rejection has also been mentioned. Now let's proceed to check the My DSpace page of the submitter. Switch back to DSpace. Let us log out this user with the reviewer role. Then log in to DSpace with the submitter's account. I will log in with my submitter's account. We are now in the submitter's My DSpace page. Notice that the rejected item submission appears in the unfinished submissions table. Submitters can correct the rejected item using the corresponding open button. After correction, the submitter can resubmit the item. Submitters can also remove an item from DSpace using the corresponding remove button. The submitter can view all the accepted submissions which are self-submitted as well. To do so, click on the View Accepted Submissions button in the My DSpace section. We will be redirected to Your Submissions page. It shows all the accepted submissions. So this is how to cross-verify accepted and rejected submissions using Submitter Authority. Let us log out this user from the DSpace interface now. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learned to accept an item review task, manage the task, and review an item in DSpace. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The Spoken Tutorial Project team conducts workshops and gives certificates. For more details, please write to us. Please post your timed queries in this forum. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by MHRD, Government of India. DSpace Spoken Tutorial Series is funded by the National Virtual Library of India, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. The script and video for this tutorial was contributed by Pankaj Patil from IIT Bombay. And this is Nancy Varkey signing off. Thanks for joining.